I'm Tiffany Sierras. My art studio is Sierras Root, and I'm here to talk about what I'm doing with my artwork these days.
I feel like I've always been an artist. I mean, I remember being 4 and 5 and talking to my sister about selling my art and making art for people. And I got very serious in high school when I had a really amazing art teacher who really embraced me and let me abuse the art room and just totally held my hand, and she was just really amazing. She just really inspired me to go for it. When my children were younger, my older 2 children, we started doing some geography club studies, and we started looking into their family heritage. And at that time, that was probably about 15 years ago, and they were studying Mexico, and we came across all this Day of the Dead art and culture, and I just thought it was amazing, and I thought it was such a unique look at death, and it was so beautiful, and it wasn't full of fear, and it just really inspired me to start making art in a new way. I always kind of wanted to portray my feelings and evoke emotions, but when I started doing this, it was like I was trying to relate to some sort of heritage that I wanted to not like remake, but kind of be a part of it. If I'm not doing it, it's just kind of lacking. So it's almost like, I don't know that there's a favorite thing, but it definitely makes me feel right. It's like, I guess that's what a calling is. You know, it's like when you have, or a passion, when you find that thing that really, it just makes your heart sing, or, you know, it makes you feel like you're actual person, you know, because when I'm not doing it, I'm not myself, and I'm just kind of off. So right now I'm doing the Dripping Springs artisan markets in the Triangle on 12 and 290 once a month. They'll start up again in the spring and go all the way through the year. I'm doing a lot of different things. I love painting. I love doing the paper mache. But when you are doing art markets and things, people want to buy things that they can use. So I'm making a lot of trinket bowls, and I make some jewelry, and I make things for kids. Kids are like my best customers. Also, if somebody sees something that they like of mine, I'm willing to work with people to do commissioned pieces. And they can contact me either through Facebook or Instagram or my Etsy store. So like, for instance, I had somebody see a piece of mine that they liked, but they wanted it in a different dimension with different colors. So I worked with that person to make that happen. And so I try to be available in different ways, in person at the markets and then also online. Some of the struggles of being a mom who is also a homeschooling mom is trying to work my own artwork in with that schedule of homeschooling and having kids. And one of the things I do that to incorporate that all together is I teach a couple of homeschool classes so that I'm doing art with kids and teaching them, and that keeps me feeling like I'm doing something important. I'm spending time with my children, and I'm teaching them something that I love and giving to the homeschooling community and just sharing art with kids. It's just fun, and kids are just amazing to work with.